In our lives, we encounter areas that act like centers or hearts, forming a grand junction from which many other fibers of our life flow. If we could see one of these hearts or centers, one might look like this. However, the interconnecting fibers will not all be straight arrows. Some will be roundabout, winding paths like these created by... Can you find the artist? If you look carefully in the upper left-hand corner, there's an earthworm. This adventure we are on together explores one doorway into one of these centers or hearts of my life. Now we enter the juncture of Jake. In December of 2010, together Tom and I stepped through the musical doorway leading to Jake Shimabukuro and his ukulele. Jake is an ukulele player traveling the world. He brings peace, love, and compassion into lives through his music. He is now accompanied by a bass player, Nolan Werner. Nolan's skills balance the ukulele's high and lively voice with a deep, grounding bass vibration. It feels good to experience them together. The duo has now connected with an electric guitar player, David Preston, who sometimes sings. Jake's songs became a doorway for me, opening a pathway to express interconnections through watercolor paintings. Each painting is itself a center or heart of interconnections, forming a story told through visible watercolor images, inspired by my experience of each song. After our first Jake concert, I began to find images coming to me around specific songs. When the images organized themselves into a pattern, it was time to begin each painting. The first one I call The Woodworker and the Ads. The song Bring Your Ads was our introduction to Jake in December of 2010. In the music world, the phrase bring your axe means bring your guitar. Jake has adapted his saying to his ukulele to bring your ads, a small axe, for his small guitar. An ads is an ancient carving tool Hawaiians use to create dugout canoes. The Living Connections. As you enter the painting, Tom is carving a canoe paddle from a piece of sassafras wood. And there's Tom holding the ads with the canoe paddle. There I am in the canoe using the finished canoe paddle. There's an image of the creek that flows in two directions where we go canoeing. The circle of lei, or lei, of leaves surrounding the painting are sassafras leaves in their soft autumn splendor. Great blue herons and river otters are members of our community that we sometimes see when we're out canoeing. When we first heard Bring Your Ads, Jake was learning about Egyptian rhythms, and he wrote a different song about Egyptian rhythms, but when I looked up the word ads in the dictionary to make sure I was spelling it correctly, it showed an Egyptian hieroglyph of a stone ads, and so the tip of the ads in the painting has that hieroglyph on it. Images for this painting started coming to me as I went for a walk, did the dishes, cooked dinner, or on my way to work. When the images organized themselves into a specific pattern, it was time to put the painting onto paper. Sometimes the process of painting changes the way I experience the song. Let us pause as we breathe in heart center and living lifelines of connections. We spoke of the weave of a basket. A different type of weave tells a different story. In this case, the story of a small bird. The fibers of the nest tell the tale of the wren and her family. The nest was right outside our porch door, so the bird family became part of our family for a spring. The pine needles, leaves, dog hair, and trimmings off Tom's beard wove a secure and safe home for Mama Bird and her babies. Their story became interwoven into our story, connecting us for a time. We received the wren's story into our own. We witnessed the bird activities in the nest of fibers. In essence, we listened to their story as the mother came and went and the babies cheeped and peeped to be fed. In this way, we received the wren's story. When we receive someone's story, we are listening. The importance of receiving, witnessing, and listening to another's story connects us to Jake's song, Blue Roses Falling. One thing that really inspired me about this song was that Jake was honored to receive his friend's grandmother's story about blue rose petals falling onto her pillow. Receiving someone's story is one way to help someone express his or herself. As I listened to the song in preparation to doing the painting, I experienced a sense of compassion in parts. I also felt phrases of the song that lifted up my spirit, as if expressing a sense of hope and healing, as if the song honored those who face challenges and that they still have dignity and a sparkling light within them. My image of dignity and sparkling light inside of us looks like this. Do you remember the times you and your grandmother connected together to share and receive each other's stories over a cup of tea or hot chocolate? River otters, seen when I met them by a huge living wall of pink blooming scented wild roses while I was out canoeing. The river otters went plop, 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 right in front of me into the water. Into the center, the featured hands belong to my grandmother. Let us pause as we breathe in what it means to receive someone's story, what it means to listen. Blue Roses Falling has phrases that to me express compassion. This connects to a different type of weave whose image can help us express compassion. Inside of a dolphin, there exists a helix spiral of interconnected fibers woven over, over, under, and under, under, over, a repeating, repeating rhythm. The layer of these fibers lies in between the blubber layer and the muscle layer. These fibers interact with muscles to give the dolphin her power during swimming. Like fibers deep inside a dolphin, compassion is woven deep within ourselves. These fibers do not look that much different than the fibers woven inside of a dolphin. The weave over, over, under, under. Compassion. As I listen to Blue Roses Falling and Jake's song Piano Forte, I feel the compassion of the universe. Compassion, to feel with, to be with. And now here is Jake's song, Piano Forte, expressed in the dance of compassion. Moving into the painting, we find ourselves surrounded by the deep green of the fir trees in the Pacific Northwest. In the presence of these giant trees, I felt a deep welling up of compassion flowing from them, flowing through their deep green fragrant branches. The hands in the center belong to our friend Mike, a very talented piano player. I learned while doing this painting the power of one small line. In drawing the hands one day, I adjusted one small line. I moved it only slightly into a different direction. The whole emotion of the picture shifted into one of compassion. Compassion of the ferns. Can you see the ferns woven into this painting? Pianoforte brings forth the compassionate relationship the ferns offer us each spring as they unfurl and uncurl powerful, potent possibilities. Soul of a fern. Unfurling, uncurling, fragrant fiddleheads, new beginnings, spirals of perfect, potent possibilities. Dear ferns, it is good to be amongst your unfurling newness, new beginnings. Tenderness. I thank you for your curving, curling, unfolding energy, new openings, healing energy. Soft, green, and tender. You are vulnerable, yet bold. Powerful gentleness. I thank you for reminding me how to simply begin again from where I stand, an expression of gratitude to you for sharing your releasing energy, your soft green light that shines out from you and through you, touching all who pass by. Beginning again. Thank you for your healing touch, the blessings of your soft voices and gentle song. I shall remember you and sing your song to the world as I breathe in your green unfurlings and new life by the lungful. Love. Holding a safe space to be in. Absolute trust. Surrender. Holding a space open. Being present with ourselves and spirit. Being present with another and all of life. Compassion, touching pain with love, but also touching joy with love. Compassion. Let us pause as we breathe in compassion.